Hello and welcome back to the Malagor episodes. I am Ashen Ninja and this is a continuation of the Beastmen on the Proving Grounds. as I've said before, we're going to go hit Cronty Mingle. So let's do that now. We could probably even auto-resolve this though. It would be devastating for my armies, so we're not going to do that. Just gonna attack. And we should be able to take these guys out without too many problems. Maybe. Lots of orcs with shields and such. Alright, let's get our deployment going. So, I want these two guys to hold flanks. So let's start with plopping a line of them in the middle. Line of them there. And we want flank. And flank. And I'll pop these guys behind. Just in case somebody gets around. You never know. We're going to pop the giant and the doom bull up the front as well. Now let's see what these guys have for me. Are they going to come for us? You, we'll pop you in the middle, but we're going to keep you within the troops here. Are they actually coming forward or are we going to have to advance on them? Quite hard to tell at the moment. Have a look at the minimap. They're sort of advancing. They're certainly doing a lot of moving around. Let's get this guy in first and then we'll slide our army forward, I think. Everybody's sort of here now, so that's... Oh, they're going to wait for us. That's fine. How far is he out from being in range? Fair way away still. I still want to make them kind of come to me. Yep.
Bah! Dark beasts! Bah!
You guys move over there, Malagor. What's their actual range? Our range isn't that good. They come close enough. Ooh, that's a bit rude, come on. What are they? They're Gobbo archers. I'm going to take a bit of damage from their ranged. You hook into them, Mr. Giant. You hook into stuff too.
Oh,
Ray scream at them. Don't think he did. I put him into combat. He is in combat. That's good. I think. He's in combat. He got them on the run now. Those orc arrow boys. These gobbo archers here. Oh, the sneaky stabbers made it. Nasty skulkers. Not sneaky stabbers. I don't know. What am I going on about today? Push him back. Go for him! Yeah! Go, Jimble! Bah, he just smashes through. I'll follow that up by going and smashing their stupid wizard. Try and shoot them out. Where are you, Malagor? Drop some knowledge on them. Go chase him down. Just follow him about the place. You'll be fine, Mr. Doombull. One of my units has copped quite a bit of a flogging here, but that's alright. No idea what they're chanting, but it doesn't sound very friendly. Keep in pursuit. There we go, that's the win. Couple of units got fairly heftily hit. How do they do? 52, not bad. How do they do? 24, 14. I keep forgetting about the dogs. Probably could have ran them around to get some gobbo archers. But, all good. It's all good. Wow, their normal gobbos did a decent job there. But still, their losses outnumbered my losses. That's the main thing. Close victory, yep. $1,200 dues. And Gronty Mingle is burnt to the ground. Lovely, lovely, lovely. We might get a thingy herd, war herd. Now the trick with one of those little spawn armies is you don't want to just kind of send them off. A lot of people do that, but it's actually not the best of ideas. So what tends to happen is they go off and get killed, then you lose reliability, then your enemies start actually, then lots of people that aren't your enemies start becoming your enemies, and before you know it, you're getting flooded, and that is something you want to avoid. Alright, let's get Malagor heading this direction. We're in good condition, which is good. Let's pop him in this tent. We've got a bit of money at the moment, so we're going to upgrade his buildings a bit. I want to get him so that he can recruit Gorbals. Or should I get him so he can recruit Shaman? We do want to get up to Cygors. Cygors are really good. But getting things like Minotaurs with shields are actually really good as well. So, We'll go with trying to get Minotaurs for the moment with him. And I'm going to go live a little dangerously and get rid of my Ungor mound. If I need Ungors in a hurry, I'll build them with Goros Heart Render. But for now, I want some more Bray Shaman. Well, I need some Bray Shaman. Alright, he seems to be doing a good job of destroying stuff there. So, we'll go with Blood of the Empire for this dilemma. Yep. Now, to help get my Minotaur a level, let's send him back to Gronti Mingo. And we pick this square. Yes, yeah, square. What's that? Magical attacks. Minus 8 leadership around self. Actually, that is fantastic. Considering that we're kind of looking for a give the enemy less leadership thing, I think giving that to our Minotaur will be a fantastic idea. And we will move these guys a bit further along here. And we'll put him in raiding stance. I'm not too concerned if I upset Wurzag. He shouldn't declare war on me at the moment. Hopefully. I guarantee nothing. 4,000 for that. 3 turns for that. I'm gonna hold off on the Minotaurs so far. Try and get a Bray Shaman first. Well, a Nurgle stink Bray Shaman at least. Let's see how we do. Alright, you have to play catch up. Now this may bring him. Why did I change his stance? That was silly. Don't need to do that. Yeah, 2 turns and he'll. He might miss out on the experience from the upcoming fight, but. Yep, we will give him that now. Oh, I didn't mean to put him into that stance. I wanted to see if I could lure that army out. Damn it. Ah, it's my fault. Screwed that up. Oh well. Yeah, Goros Heartrender. If I wanted to actually lead him in raiding stead to try and lure that army out so that we could kill it in the field. Alright. What we will do instead is this turn. So he's got 12, I've got 19. And we've got this guy. Let me pop him there. He's still got one more turn before I can get them. Oh, that's right, I want that building too. Very important building, that one. Reducing his cost by 25%, then 50% as well when you get up to the top tier one. At which point it does become a lot more viable for lots and lots of Saigors. Will they come out at me? their lord. That's just what I resolve it. I lost two. Still, it's a win. A bunch more experience. That's one of the weird things the AI started doing. And not even just in Proving Grounds, I've noticed it's doing it all over the place. Yep. Okay, let's move him to about there. Yep. That stance, and let's get you your ritual mound. Excellent. Unassigned skill points. Yep. More from raiding, that's good. Make him better at stuff around him. That way he just inspires the soldiers under him and wrecks stuff. Hardcore. What will you do this time? Oh, where's that got into in there? That's a bummer. Well, he can actually use that other lord to take Ironstone Mine. Then I can burn down Ironstone Mine again. Ooh, hello. Ambush failed. Oh, well. Apparently that doesn't matter. He still attacks me anyway. He's in march stance, so I guess what we're going after. One tired army. Causes fear and terror. Ooh. I hoped he already did. Oh. Well, whatever. Let's see. Now this would be for Lightning Strike. That's Horde Growth. Horde Growth is good. I'll take the rating. Alright, you, my friend, will reduce my recruitment cost. You! We'll give him that one. Now, you move to about there. You move to about there, and we're gonna quickly. What? I didn't finish building that. That makes me. That annoys me. Just auto resolve it. That's good. Take replenishment. Ooh, a banner of eternal flame. Don't actually mind those. They get derided quite a lot, but I like them. Alright, yep, another crack at that one. Let's see, what about you? You need four more turns and you can build your Minotaur building. That's good. Go through the blue line for the moment, then we're going to jump into the red line. Yeah. Large recruitment costs more. Now, is that actually the end of that orc clan? I think it was. What we'll do, just now that Wurzag's done, exactly that, is destroy Wurzag, because he's right here. I knew he was going to do that. That means we can take out Wurzag, and we should be able to hit Ekrund as well, because Ekrund will have fairly minimal forces. This time we're at quite high, so we don't need that. Tired. What a pain in the ass. I'll take Wyvern One Falls because it's just the best of them. Let's see. Come on. Shadows. Knowledgeable. I'm going to believe it. I don't actually want knowledgeable. I want Nurgle's foul stench. For that, we're going to. Let's see. Who's a warden? Let's see.
What?
Border princes. You want to join?
We may not be the
no, I can't actually have you. Can't join you in war. There you go. I won't join them in war then. I'll just go to war with Wozak. He's got a fair little army. Oh, he's got a giant too. Declare war on Wozak. Alright. His giant versus my giant. Is not gonna happen, hopefully. So we'll try and get other units into that fight instead. But you never know. Never know. Either way, let's get into fighting. I don't want to lose my giant. Alrighty. He shouldn't have a very high level, I'd say. So we should be right to still do a relatively tight formation. Gotta make sure we got plenty of spears amongst the main troops. We will. That in nice and close there. You gotta hang there. You can't deploy either of them, any of these guys all the way up there. In that case, I'm actually gonna move the whole lot of these guys back. Yep. Fail. Click the correct button. That always helps. Alrighty, and our extra lord will come in, and let's get everyone going forward. What happened there? What is going on with that? That's better. Yep, get them going up a little bit faster. Let's see. No, we're still well out of range. Righty-o, Malagor. Start by plopping down a spell. Oh, he's plopping down a spell too. Oh, yep. Exchanging spellfire, eh? Now, what we want to do is shoot the crap out of him. You shoot them. Because the best way. Oh, jeez. I think that's brain burster, isn't it? The best way to fight a giant is actually with ranged firepower. Because they have a sweet fuck all army and they're a big ass target. Oh, Malagor, you pull back a bit, will ya? Try and hit Wurzag. Okay, that was bad. No, that didn't work at all. That's fine. We'll just pull them back again. His army's already pretty melted. His spell does much more damage than mine. But that's alright. It's alright. Oh yeah, oh, he's anti-large as well, so yeah. So definitely a good call, bringing the Minotaur in to fight him. That Wurzag's coming forward a bit. He won't take well to get shot up too much either, I don't think. Yeah. Ooh. Man, his magic's nasty though. There we go, it's shattered them. There we go, very nice. ...154 losses, yeah, mostly through Wurzag. Oh no, mostly through one of their Savage Orc units. But then anyway, my units are super squishy. Super little. Poor little fellas. We'll raise and defile that one. Just because there's not a lot of money to be made in it. And who doesn't like a good defiling every now and then? Let's see. Lightning strike for you, just in case. I like to have it in my back pocket, just in case. Recruitment, minus 10%, lovely. Ekrand is probably going to be our target next time. A bit of stone mine is gone. So it's kind of how you need to do it at the start. You just gotta aim for those little guys. Take out the little hanging cherries. That's alright. He'll just follow me around. Come from raiding. Goros Heartrender. Beautiful. Malagor got himself the Bray Herd. And we're going to go for Fell Rituals. Beautiful. With the Bray Herd doing something like taking Ekrand will be easy. So won't have anything to really fight us with. Whoops. Oh, you hang there. That's fine. And it will go well. Now what we want is not cunning. We want none of those. So we're going to take cunning, recruit him, and disband him. Now, that actually might go for,
Get out of me head!
I have to say what it'll do, actually. Wow, that's actually a pretty gauze. Gauze, razor gauze. Yeah, that's pretty nice. I like it. Alright, well, we've made it to this point. Better than I was probably expecting to do, to be honest. I'm generally pretty rubbish at Beastmen. But there you go. So, alright, it looks like a tree. Alright, well, that's episode 2 down. So, if you've liked this and liked the amount of battles, etc., then do the usual of subscribing and that sort of thing. And I will see you in the next episode. Till then, have a good one.